Hey, thank you for joining us at Prophecy in the News for this update. I'm your host, Kevin Clarkson. Really pleased to have in our studio today, Billy Crone. Billy is well known to many of our followers, and he is a pastor from Las Vegas, Nevada, as well as a real researcher and presenter of all things end time, second coming. Welcome, sir.
Hey, thank you, Dr. Clarkson. It's always great to be on.
Well, it's good to have you again.
Yeah.
And one of the things, you know, you began as kind of Mr. Researcher and really good at it, and you put this together in such, I think, articulate packages. And one of the things I've been seeing in the last few years, you've had all these really video products, and they're great.
Yeah.
But you're beginning to get a team to help you commit this to writing. And
yeah.
You're putting out books. And
yeah.
your newest one we want to just talk about for a minute, because we're
okay.
going to do a show on it,
okay.
is called UFOs, The Great Last Days Deception.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, well, there's a teaser if I ever heard one.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You know, the X-Files is coming back in
yep.
a reissue. That was a popular 90s show.
Yeah.
And it was about the supposed government cover-up of all things conspiratorial and UFOs.
Yeah.
And not only that, over this recent holiday weekend, there was a marathon on one of the channels of the old original X-Files series. So I kind of, I spent probably a few more hours than I needed to kind of reliving some of that.
Yeah,
but I know that's just intriguing, and you've got all the stats, so I'll quit talking and let you tell us what this is about.
Yeah, well, no, and again, you're right. Not only with the media, it seems to be coming up again, the UFOs and aliens
and that whole time. News.
Oh, absolutely,
sightings, you know.
And our world's enthralled with it,
yeah.
And the media is doing a great job to drive that interest as well, of course. And even in the news, there's mm-hmm. Recent news in Arizona. You got two hot off the press. It's still out there. Two airline pilots, man, what did we see? UFO and all that stuff?
These are commercial pilots, is that right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And this the sighting in Arizona there. But also there's a bit recent one in North Carolina and some stuff. Is it military? Is it UFO? I mean, it's just, it seems to be ramping up again.
And is there still heavy traffic supposedly over Israel?
That one I haven't heard about
yet. You know, they've always, they claim there's been a lot of sightings in Israel.
Well, and
proportionate to the size of the land.
Yeah, and we actually document that in the book.
Yeah.
Some of the stuff that's going on in Israel. Again, that's a global hotspot, of course.
And you mentioned when we were talking before we came on about, you know, the Catholic interest and what the Pope has said. Just tell us about that.
Well, that's like, man, what are you reading, a comic book or something?
I
or
know.
Science fiction? No, it's all documented. But even the Vatican, of course, for years has not just been interested in UFOs. Of course, they have bought in, unfortunately, to the lie of evolution.
Mm-hmm.
And so they're looking for this higher evolved race. But they're not just looking. And they not only have their own observatories, and their own Vatican astronomers, but they really believe that they're trying to be the first ones to, quote, find them, and they want to be the ones to make imminent disclosure. Even Pope Francis, in the news, it's on record, he said he'd be willing to baptize an alien, and you're going, what's all that about? Well, the astronomers from the Vatican actually even made statements to the effect that basically they believe that alien life is not just real, but that's what we're really reading in the Bible when we see angels.
Mm-hmm.
It's really the ETs. That's just their way of trying to explain it, number one. Number two, they say, well, and therefore these guys are closer to God, and they may not even have a sin nature. So that means whatever they say when they come here, we need to submit what they say and even reinterpret the gospel according to what they share. This is what's going on.
Yeah.
I'm not making it up. It's like, what kind of deception, hence the title, UFOs, the Great Last Days Deception. What kind of deception is coming to this planet?
That kind of goes back to maybe when the 60s, when Eric von Däniken came out with, he's a Dutch writer, came out with the whole idea of chariots of the gods.
Yeah.
Ezekiel's vision was actually a UFO.
Yeah.
And, you
yeah.
know, the being he saw surrounded by light. And
right.
It's a recasting of scripture, and it's pure deception.
Well, and that's it. This deception is, and of course, the whole premise, if you stop and think about it, UFOs, it's based on a lie.
Mm-hmm.
And because what's the premise? They supposedly come all the way across the universe to what? They tell us who they are. A higher evolved race. Stop right there. You just used evolution.
Yeah.
Well, evolution's a lie.
Right.
And if evolution can't happen on this planet, and it can, it's not going to happen on any planet.
Right.
So right out of the gates, before you did anything, said anything else, your whole premise is a lie. What's the Bible say? John chapter 8, who's the father of all lies? Satan. So that tells you something demonic is going on here. People are being deceived. And of course they are. And this kind of dovetails, ultimately, we lead you into a biblical understanding of who are these critters, if you will, and what are they really doing here? But based on their behavior, based on what they're saying, based on their characteristics, you compare it with the scripture, it's a demonic deception, and it is leading somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
It is leading towards the ultimate explanation to explain away the rapture of the church for those left behind. And that's not just something I'm pulling out of my own head.
Right.
This is part of my background. As you know, my testimony from the occult and New Age. New Age is steeped in UFOlogy.
Yes, it is.
It's almost carbon copy. If you're going to get New Age, you're going to get into this topic.
They've already written what they, you know, plan to say when this event occurs.
And I quote many sources of their New Age sources that are channeling, which is demonic, by the way, and these aliens speaking through them, supposedly. But what they're saying is, don't be surprised if perhaps 20 million people leave the planet at one time. And what they say is, don't be shocked. Okay, those people can't handle what's coming. And then they say what's coming is not a bad thing, the seven-year tribulation.
Right.
It's a good thing. They say it's Mother Earth cleansing herself, and that you who are left behind, you're a chosen one. You just need to hang on, and then on the back end, you'll make it to utopia. So they explain away the rapture of the church, and it's not just an excuse. It's a brilliant set-up excuse for decades, getting people to fall for the lie of UFOs first, then you fall for the explanation of the rapture of the church to explain it away, and then they get people to think who are left behind that this is the best thing ever when Jesus said this is the worst time in the history of mankind.
That's right.
Tell me that's not demonic.
It's a total inversion of the truth and perversion of the gospel.
Right, exactly.
And we're going to fully explore this in a program. I look forward to that, and you be sure and catch that on Prophecy in the News. Thank you for joining us.